All I once held dear, built my life upon. All this world reveres and wars to own. All I once thought gained, I now counted lost. Spent and worthless now compared to this. No.
Now my heart's desire is to know you more, to be found in you and known as yours, to possess by faith what I could not earn, all-surpassing gift of righteousness. Good morning and a warm welcome to Christ Church for this service of morning worship on the 8th of January 2023, and may I wish you a very happy new year. Today we are looking at the baptism of Christ. Paul Hunt will be preaching to us, Stuart Gibbs brings us our Bible readings, and John Friend will be leading us in prayer. Just a couple of notices. Our new venture, Anna's Place, starts on Tuesday, the 10th of January at 10 o'clock. If you would like to be involved in this venture in any way, please contact the Reverend Margaret Fowler. Secondly, several people have asked when Frank Copper's funeral is, and I can now confirm that that will be on Friday, the 3rd of February at 11:30 at Bentley Crematorium. And June would be delighted for as many people as possible to be there to celebrate Frank's life. So now, as we begin our service, please join with me in the words in bold. Grace, mercy and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you, and also with you. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Lord, direct our thoughts. Teach us to pray. Lift up our hearts to worship you in spirit and in truth. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And as we start the new year, we come now to our time of confession. A chance to bring to the Lord anything that went wrong, anything we're not happy about, anything we feel we could have done better, and to ask his forgiveness and his blessing as we go on into January and beyond. Lord Jesus Christ, we confess that we have failed you as did your first disciples. We ask for your mercy and your help. Most merciful God, we confess to you before the whole company of heaven and one another that we have sinned in thought, word and deed, and in what we have failed to do. Forgive us our sins, heal us by your Spirit, and raise us to new life in Christ. Amen. May the God of love bring us back to himself. Forgive us our sins and assure us of his eternal love in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now Stuart brings us our Bible readings for today.
Today's Old Testament reading is Isaiah 42 verses 1 to 9. Here is my servant whom I uphold, my chosen one in whom I delight. I will put my spirit on him, and he will bring me justice to the nations. He will not shout or cry out or raise his voice in the streets. A bruised reed he will not break, and a smouldering wick he will not snuff out. In faithfulness he will bring forth justice. He will not falter or be discouraged, till he establishes justice on earth. In his teaching the islands will put their hope. This is what the Lord says, the creator of the heavens who stretches them out, who spreads out the earth with all that springs from it, who gives breath to its people and life to those who walk on it. I, the Lord, have called you in righteousness. I will take hold of your hand. I will keep you and will make you to be a covenant for the people and a light for the Gentiles, to open the eyes that are blind, to free captives from prison, and to release from the dungeon those who sit in darkness. I am the Lord, that is my name. I will not yield my glory to another or praise to idols. See, the former things have taken place, and new things I declare before they spring into being. I announce them to you. Today's New Testament reading is Matthew 3:13 to the end. Baptism of Jesus. Then Jesus came from Galilee to John at the Jordan to be baptized by him. John would have prevented him, saying, I need to be baptized by you, and do you come to me? But Jesus answered him, let it be so now, for it is proper for us in this way to fulfill all righteousness. Then he consented. And when Jesus had been baptized, just as he came up from the water, suddenly the heavens were opened to him, and he saw God's Spirit descending like a dove and alighting on him. And a voice from heaven said, this is my Son, the Beloved, with whom I am well pleased. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Good morning and welcome. I hope you're all well. Today's two readings explore a prophecy that was written 700 years before Jesus was born and talks about a servant that God was going to bring to the world, and also the baptism of Jesus, and it describes in detail what Jesus's baptism was like. So let's explore what we can learn from both of those readings today. We need to start talking about a job description when we are talking about the baptism of Jesus. But bear with me a moment. Now, job description is a document that clearly states essential requirements, duties, responsibilities, and skills required to perform a specific role. A detailed job description will cover how success is measured as well in the role, so it can be used in performance management. So, how has that got anything to do with today's readings? Well, in our Old Testament reading today, which was written about 700 years before the birth of Jesus, we hear about the servant. And I feel that this is almost like a job description of the mission and character of Jesus, who was to come 700 years after this Old Testament reading was written. The servant that is described in the passage is understood by Christians to be Jesus. And I do think it reads a little like a job description, the qualities and the roles that Jesus would have in the future. So in the book of Isaiah, the prophecy about Jesus, the servant of God, came to bring justice and hope to the world. But it's also a reminder that Jesus was gentle and kind, and that he cared for people that were weak or hurt. He didn't shout or cry out because he knew that love and kindness can speak louder than words. Our reading from today says, "I, the Lord, have called you in righteousness. I will take hold of your hand. I will keep you and make you to be a covenant for the people and a light for the Gentiles, to open eyes that are blind, to free captives from prison and to release from the dungeon those who sit in darkness." Now this tells us that God has a special purpose for Jesus, and he also has a special purpose for each and every one of us. He has called us all by name, and he has a plan for our lives. And we aren't small or unimportant in God's eyes. We are all equally important. He has given us the ability to be a light for others, to share his love and hope with those around us. And God had that plan for Jesus too, as we learn from our Old Testament reading. In the New Testament reading for today, we learn about the baptism of Jesus. So what do we know about baptism? Well, it involves water, doesn't it? Now, water is an amazing substance. There's a variety of water uses, such as drinking, swimming, cooking, bathing, cleaning. Water is a very powerful liquid. You might even be able to hear the rain outside as I'm talking to you. And do you know that 71% of the Earth's surface is made up of water? That's why we call it the Blue Planet. And around 60% of the human body itself is made up of water. That's amazing to think, isn't it? But water is really important in baptism. And baptism helps us to remember that God has saved us and washed away our sins. I've been lucky enough to see several baptisms in church, and most have used a font. One has used an inflatable hot tub, and I've also seen a baptism in a swimming pool, and also on the banks of the River Thames in Southend. And I was baptised myself as a baby. Now, I don't remember the day too well, but I do have the photos, and I can see it was a big family occasion. Lots of smiles, happy faces, and all of our grandparents, aunts and uncles and cousins there. Along, of course, with Mum and Dad, in the same church that Mum and Dad got married. It was a special occasion for us all. And it does remind us that when we're born, we're not born perfect. There will be times when we do the wrong thing. We make the wrong choice. Sometimes that choice is by mistake, sometimes is deliberate. But God will forgive us. He sent Jesus to take our place and die so that we can live with God. Now, it might seem odd to think that Jesus, the perfect Jesus, Son of God, was baptized. After all, why? But he was. So why would he need to be baptized? Well, John asked the same question. Remember John, the camel hair wearing, lotus eating person I spoke to you in the past? He baptized people in the River Jordan to show that they were sorry for their sins and wanted to follow God. They wanted to repent. And Jesus came to him one day asking to be baptized. And John tried to send him away, saying, I need to be baptized by you, and do you come to me? He was confused, clearly. But Jesus insisted, saying he needed to do it. It was part of God's plan, linking back to our Old Testament reading earlier. So John baptized Jesus in the River Jordan. And when Jesus was baptized, the heavens opened, and the Holy Spirit came down like a dove. And the voice of God was heard saying, This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased. Can you imagine being there at that moment, seeing Jesus being baptized and the heavens open and the Holy Spirit descending? It must have been amazing and beautiful, perhaps just a little scary. Jesus being baptized reminds us that even Jesus, who was perfect and without sin, was following God's plan and was baptized. It shows us that being baptized is an important way to show that we want to follow God and be part of his family. And it reminds us that God loves us very much and is always with us, even when we can't see him. So next time we use water, whether it be washing the dishes or the car or washing our hands, think about baptism. Think about Jesus being baptized by John, that special event that reminds us of God's love and the importance of following his plan in our lives. It is a time to remember that we are special and loved by God. He has a purpose for us. And he will be with us every step of the way. Let's not let our size or our age hold us back. We can all make a difference in the world by sharing God's love with others. Let's finish today with a prayer, thanking God for the gift of baptism. Dear God, we come before you today to give thanks for the baptism of Jesus. We are grateful that through baptism, Jesus set an example for us to follow. We thank you for the forgiveness of our sins that is made possible through Jesus' death and resurrection. We pray that we may always remember the significance of baptism and will try to live our lives in a way that brings glory to you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Do you feel the world is broken?
We do.
Do you feel the shadows deepen?
We do.
But do you know that all the dark won't stop the light from getting through?
We do.
Do you wish that you could see it all made new?
We do.
Is all creation groaning?
It is.
Is a new creation coming?
It is.
Is the glory of the Lord to be the light within the mist?
It is.
Is it good that we remind ourselves of this? Is he worthy? Is he worthy? of all blessing and honor and glory. Is he worthy of this? He is. Does the Father truly love us? Does the Spirit move among us?
He does.
And does Jesus, our Messiah, hold forever those he loves?
He does.
Does our God intend to dwell again with us? Seal and open the scroll. The Lion of Judah, who conquered the grave, he is David's root and the Lamb who died to ransom the slave from every people and tribe, every nation and tongue. He has made us a kingdom and priests to God, to reign with the Son. Is he worthy? Is he worthy of all blessing and honor and glory? Is he worthy? Is he worthy? Is he worthy of this? He is. Oh, is he worthy? Is he worthy? He is. He is.
Thank you very much, Paul, for your message to us this morning. And now we have a chance to respond to that message and to our readings by affirming our faith. If you are able to and would like to do so, please stand. Do you believe and trust in God the Father, the source of all being and life? The one for whom we exist. We believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us, and rose again? We believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world? We believe and trust in him. This is the faith of the Church. This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. And now John will lead us in prayer.
In the reading from Isaiah, we heard, God created the heavens and stretched them out, who spread the earth and all that comes out of it. If we spare a thought, who else could have arranged for our planet to circle the sun each year and give us the seasons to grow food? Who knows the number of stars in the sky, or can explain how space is expanding? For thousands of years, our planet Earth has provided all our needs and more. Yet lately we have turned away from working with nature to exploiting nature. Lord, we pray you will let wisdom prevail and give guidance and strength to our leaders to show us all how to restore equilibrium with nature on earth. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. In church, we are having a family communion service. Let us pray for our children. Give us the grace, Lord, to tell our children the truth and nothing but the truth, to issue no idle threats or promises, to keep our word, to apologise when we have been wrong, to be disciplined over time, to be courteous in all our dealings, to answer children's questions as honestly and as simply as we can, to let them help in all the ways we can devise, to expect from them no higher standard of honesty, unselfishness, politeness than we are prepared to live up to ourselves. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus, we pray for those who will be unhappy today, for those for whom Christmas was not a happy occasion. We pray for those who remember loved ones who are no longer with us, and those who are sick. For parents who have no food to cook for their children. For those who will be cold this winter. For those who cannot earn enough money to support their families. For children who are sick and frightened. And for all who are alone and without people to love them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of peace and justice, we pray for the people of Ukraine and all those involved in war and conflict. We pray for peace and the laying down of weapons. We pray for all those who fear for tomorrow, that your spirit of comfort would draw near to them. We pray for those who have power over war or peace, for wisdom, discernment, and compassion to guide their decisions. Above all, we pray for all your children, at risk and in fear, that you would hold and protect them. We pray in Jesus' name. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. During the busy Christmas period, many people, both adults and children, have attended spiritual gatherings in church, maybe for the first time. Father, we pray that any spark of interest in Jesus will grow within them, and they will be stimulated to find out more, and that we too, with your guidance and wisdom, will help also to spread your word. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. As Jesus taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. The Collect for the Baptism of Christ. Heavenly Father, at the Jordan, you reveal Jesus as your Son. May we recognize him as our Lord and know ourselves to be your beloved children through Jesus Christ our Saviour. Amen.
And our final song of worship for this morning, Lord Jesus Christ. And as we close our service this morning, a reminder that if you need anything, please contact the office or one of the wardens or Margaret. All contact details are given on the screen as the service finishes. It's been really lovely to worship with you all today. May I wish you a very good week and a very good year as we go now in Christ's name. So we say our closing prayer. Almighty God, we thank you for the gift of your holy word. May it be a lantern to our feet, a light upon our paths, and a strength to our lives. Take us and use us to love and serve all people in the power of the Holy Spirit and in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So let's go in peace to love and to serve the Lord. In the name of Christ, Amen.